and welcome to the geography class. In this class we are going to see about the fifth topic. The fifth topic is speaking about the physiographic features of India. So in this topic we are going to talk and discuss about the two physiographic features of India. So I welcome to you all and let's start our class. Chapter number 2, physical features of India. Topic number 4, we are going to discuss here the two physiographic features of India. In the first presentation, we talked about the Great Himalaya Mountain. In the second presentation, again we continue with the Himalaya Mountain. In the third presentation, we talk and discuss about the Northern Plain. After Northern Plain, we talk about the Peninsular Plateau. And now, we are talking about the Great Indian Desert and the Coastal Plain. So let's move to talk and discuss about these. So but first point is here, when we are seeing this, the Indian Desert, so our mind is directly carrying us to the Rajasthan, because in Rajasthan the Indian Desert is situated and the name of the desert is the Thar Desert. As we are talking about the desert, in our mind the sand dunes will appear, in our mind camel will appear. The camel is known as the ship of the desert. So let's see the first topic, the Indian Desert. So here, as I stated to you, the greatest Indian desert. You are seeing here, in this photograph, you are seeing camel, the person and this. These are the Karachis, the sand dunes. So the Thar Desert, the great Indian desert, we are going to talk about that, the Thar Desert. First, the Indian Desert lies towards the western margin of Arabian Hills. As in our previous presentation, when we were talking about the Peninsular Plateau, in that we were discussing about Arabian Hills. So, Arabian Hills, western, the desert is there. So, the Indian Desert lies toward the margin, western margins of the Arabian Hills. It is the undulating sandy plains covered with the sand dunes. As we had seen in the previous photograph, the sand dunes, they are having covered with the sand dunes and sandy plain area. The region receives very low rainfall. The desert world, by hearing the desert, we are knowing scanty vegetation, lack of water, there is a water scarcity, the vegetation is very low, rainfall is very low, many things. So there is very low rainfall and below 150 millimeter per year. It has arid soil. So arid is one type of soil. Arid is the name of one type of soil. Desert soil we can also speak about, or arid soil. We can speak arid soil or a desert soil. And climate with the low vegetation. Vegetation will be very low. And the reason why? Because in desert there is a lack of water. As we are talking about, very less rainfall is there. So let's move to discuss this. So these are the points which are talking about the features of Great Indian Desert. Next, the streams appear during the rainy season. So which stream? So we are talking about the water streams. So here we are talking about the rivers. So the streams are appearing only at the time of rainy season. So rainy season will be there, low rainfall will be there. So the water will appear in that. But what happened? Soon after, they disappear into the sand as they do not have enough water to reach the sea. So the rivers are disappearing because they don't have that much amount of water to reach to the sea. And the Luni is the longest river over there. So here, the Luni is only the larger river in this region and the longest river. So Luni is the name of the river which is present in this Thar Desert. So here the physical features we are talking about. So physical features talking about what? The first point we are speaking about there, the climate is too much hot. The climate is not favorable for more vegetation. Why? Because the scarcity of water. Second point we talked about that the arid soil is there. Third point we are talking about that the life of the peoples are having depending on the water scarcity. So they are depending on only rainy season, and in rainy season only the Looney River is there, and few streams are there which are disappearing because they don't have enough water. So these are the features. Looney River, first one. Then we are talking about how the streams are disappearing and why, because they don't have enough water. Next, branches cover. So what is this branches? So right, so this branches cover the large areas, right? Right, areas, but longitudinal dunes become more prominent near the Indo-Pakistan boundary. Near the Indo-Pakistan boundaries, these branches are more. If you visit the Jaisalmer, you may go to see a group of branches. So these branches, we will see about what are they and how are they. They are the sand dunes facing the wind, and how the wind is making the definite shape. See, these are the branches. The wind is here and making the different shapes. See, these are the branches. Here also all the sand is here. You can see this photograph, the scanty vegetation. The vegetation is very scanty. So thorny forest will be there here. Why? Because the less rainfall is there. See here. See this photograph. The wind is coming from this and just blowing the sand in this one, and this arch shape is forming. So this is the example of branches. Next, we are going to discuss about the next topic, the next physiographic features of India, that is the coastal plain. This is the fifth physiographic features of India. So here coastal plain, as I am talking about, so this is the coastal plain. By seeing the photograph, we can understand about these are the coastal plains. Moving to discuss about, we are having the two coastal plain, western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. As in our previous presentation, we talked about the Western Ghat, Eastern Ghat. The Western Ghat besides the Western Coastal Plain will be there. Eastern Ghat, so near thereby, so Eastern Coastal Plain will be there, and we will see the dividation of this Eastern Coastal Plain and Western Coastal Plain. So let's see about the coastal plain. Next, the peninsular plateau is flanked by stretch of narrow coastal strips running along the Arabian Sea on the west and the Bay of Bengal in the east. When we are talking about the coastal plain, we are talking about first the Arabian Sea, and between the Western Ghat we are having the Western Coastal Plain. Again we are talking about Bay of Bengal and the Eastern Ghat, between that the Eastern Coastal Plain is there. So the Western Coastal sandwiched between the Western Ghat and the Arabian Sea is a narrow plain. The plain is narrow. We are talking here about, it is just like a sandwich. Western Ghat is here, Western Ghat, and this Western Coastal Plain is here, and Arabian Sea. So it's just like a sandwich between them. So between the Western Ghat and the Arabian Sea, and the plain is narrow. Then we are moving to discuss about, this is the Western Coastal Plain. Next we will talk about Eastern Coastal Plain. Next, it consists of the three sections. Which one? We are continuing with the Western Coastal Plain. So Western Coastal Plain, we are bifurcating into the three parts. So the three sections, northern part coast is called as Konkan, that is from Mumbai up to Goa, and the central stretch is called as the Kannad Plain or Kannad Plain, while the southward stretch is referred to the Malabar coast. So here, so Kannad Plain means to be south to Goa there. So Konkan, this Kannad and Malabar coast. So it is divided into three. Next, the plain along the Bay of Bengal, wide and level. The northern part of refers to the northern Chilka, while the southern part is called as Coromandel coast. So here we are talking about the eastern. Next, the larger rivers such as Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri have formed extensive delta on this coast. Which coast? Eastern coastal plain. So like Chilika. So Lake Chilika is an important feature along the eastern coast. So here the differentiation is there between the western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. Let's see the Lake Chilika and where it is. So do you know the Chilika Lake is the largest saltwater lake in India. It's like in the states of which? Which state? Odisha, to the south of Mahanadi Delta. So make a note of it. Chilika Lake is the largest salt lake and saltwater lake in India, and it's like in which state? It's like in Odisha. Next, you can see here, this is Bay of Bengal, this is the Odisha state, this is the Chilika Lake. This is the largest saltwater lake in India. Moving to next. See, this is the one view picturization of Chilika Lake. Next, here I am going to talk and discuss about with this help of the map. As I am speaking in the sentence, so little bit sometimes it is going to be confusing to you. Sir is talking about what? So here is clear picture talking about the area mark with the black shape indicate the coastal plain. So here we are talking about the coastal plain. This black part is talking about indicating the coastal plain. So I will explain you very firmly over here. This part is called as western coastal plain. This part is called as eastern coastal plain. So eastern coastal plain is broader. This coastal plain is narrow. And this is divided into three. As we are talking about Malabar coast, Kannad coast and Konkan coast. Konkan, Kannad and Malabar coast. So Coromandel coast and Sirsar coast. Next, here India's physiographic features are all here. First one already we discussed about the Himalaya mountain. Second one already we discussed about the northern plain. Then third one already we discussed about the Deccan plateau. Fourth, just now we discussed about the Aravalli mountain, and here we are having the great Indian desert. We discussed about this. Now we are discussing about here the fifth one. This is the coastal plain. Coastal plain. So here, see this map very properly. Here we are talking about Western Ghat. So just beside of Western Ghat, we are having Western Coastal Plain. Eastern Ghat, just like that, aside to it, we are having Eastern Coastal Plain. So here it is divided into Konkan up to here. Then we are having the Kannad, then we are having Malabar. Here Coromandel coast and northern Sirsar coast is there. So it can be asked in the differentiation. Difference you have to write western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. So western coastal plain, where they are? So Western Ghat and Arabian Sea. Western Ghat and Arabian Sea, between the western coastal plain is here. This side, eastern coastal plain and Bay of Bengal, the eastern coastal plain. This is Western Ghat, sorry, Eastern Ghat, and this is Bay of Bengal. And between that is there, just like a sandwich. So Eastern Ghat and Bay of Bengal, between that the eastern coastal plain is there. Then they are narrow and they are broad. Because the rivers are coming, which river? Krishna, Godavari, then these rivers are the bigger rivers are coming, so they are making this one delta type here. So this area, a coastal plain, is larger than this western one. Once again I will repeat it. Western coastal plain is divided into three: Konkan, Kannat and Malabar coast. And here the northern Sirkar here and Coromandel coast. Then we are talking about its location, Western Ghat and Arabian Sea. The western coastal plain is situated between the Western Ghat and Arabian Sea. The eastern coastal plain is situated between the Eastern Ghat and Bay of Bengal. So the differentiation is coming. Then we are talking about it is narrow. By seeing this, it looks small. So it's narrow. It's so broad. So it's broad. And the reason why, due to the depositional features of the river, that's the Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri river. So with this help of this map, it's clear to us about the western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain and about the Great Indian Desert. Next, going towards the overview. The overview is speaking about what? The Indian Desert, as we talked about, it's having the sandy. Its situation is very, very harsh climate and lying here in the western margin of Aravali Hills is the Indian Desert. Then we talked about the Barjans. I had shown you the photograph of Barjan. Then it is having a very less rainfall, around how much millimeters? 150 millimeter. And the Luni is the only large river over there. And vegetation is very scanty. Temperature is too high. And the name of the desert is Thar Desert, or we can speak about the Great Indian Desert. And the soil name is arid soil, or we can speak desert soil. Next, the overview of coastal plain. The narrow coastal strip flanked to the peninsular plateau. We are talking about the peninsular plateau. Both the sides we are having the coastal plain. So west side western coastal plain, east side eastern coastal plain. As we talked about Konkan, Kannat plain and Malabar coast, and the Bay of Bengal and the White River, and the eastern coast is divided into northern and Coromandel coast and northern to the south part. Next, this overview is very important. Lastly, moving to the thanks to you. Before going for the thanking, you please copy it down this too. This overview is very important. Have a few seconds to just copy it down this. What we talked and discussed, the Great Indian Desert and the coastal plain. Have a few seconds. Please copy it down. After that, I will place the homework for you. So overview is speaking about the Indian Desert. You can make your own point also, which we had discussed about the Indian Desert. You can write down from the notebook also. In your notebook, you have to bifurcate the points 1 point, 2 point, 3 point, 5 point. Yes. Please see this map once again to make you more clear. To make you more clear, Great Indian Desert, this is Aravali Range, western to Aravali, Aravali is here, east side this, west side to Aravali, the Great Indian Desert is there. So the location is fixed here, the Great Indian Desert, where it is? Westward to the Aravali Range. Then here, the longest river is Luni. Second point, scanty vegetation. Third point, low rainfall up to 150 millimeter. Temperature is too high. And the streams are appearing only in the rainy season, and after that they are disappearing. So why they are disappearing? Because they don't have that much amount of water to reach up to the sea. So why I am speaking all the features like this? Because in examination, the question will appear like this. Write a short note on the Great Indian Desert. 5 marks question will come. For that point, you have to mention the 5 points. First point, where it is situated. It is called as Thar Desert or Great Indian Desert. Situated in Rajasthan, westward to Aravali Hills. Second point, the largest river is Duni. The stream used to appear in rainy season and used to disappear because of lack of water. Then scanty vegetation, then low rainfall up to 150 millimeter. Like that, we have to think of 5 points, that means the 5 features of the Great Indian Desert. After that, we are coming to the coastal plain. If for the coastal plain, the question will not come for the 5 marks, the question will come for differentiate between the western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. The topics are very important. Every year this question is appearing in the examination. For that purpose, I am explaining you western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. So western coastal plain divided into 3 parts. So eastern coastal plain divided into 2 parts. Then the western coastal plain is narrow and eastern coastal plain is broad. And the reason why, what you have to write about that, the rivers are going, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, the large rivers are going and their deposit features making the coastal plain broad. So next you have to talk about this location, Western Ghat and Arabian Sea. Between that, the western coastal plain is there. Eastern Ghat and Bay of Bengal, between that, the eastern coastal plain is there. Like that, you have to write the questions and their answer. So here I am giving you the 2 questions. First question is that, write a short note on the Great Indian Desert. So how to write, I explain to you. Then the second question is, differentiate between the western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. So next, what you have to do? You have to make a column to write the differentiation and you have to make 5 points to write about the Great Indian Desert. And how the question will come? Describe the 5 features of Great Indian Desert. Otherwise, write a short note on the Great Indian Desert. Here, differentiate, write any 3 difference of the western coastal plain and eastern coastal plain. So this map is very, very important. From the first presentation, I am talking about this presentation, the physiographic feature, the first physiographic feature, second physiographic feature, third, fourth and fifth physiographic feature, we have finished in this presentation. In the next presentation, we are going to talk and discuss about the 6th physiographic feature of India. That means we are going to talk about the islands. This means Lakshadweep and Andaman and Nicobar. So in this presentation, whatever we have studied here, you please make a note of it. Once again, I want to show you the slides and please copy down the points. Please copy down these points. Next, this point, whatever I had explained, you can make the point also. You can write it from the NCERT textbook also, from the chapter number 2. The same, it is given like that. Lastly, I want to thank each and everyone for watching this one. If you are having any doubt, any difficulty, you please let me know. We will take your points and we will discuss here. And till now, be safe and be happy and Jai Hind to one and all.